Alright, what I got here is three coils that are going to run as a driver. I'm going to run, let me disconnect these. I'm going to run just one at first. Because as I add them, it'll go faster. I have more torque. This is a voltmeter, 1.2 millivolts. This is going to be an amp meter. This is running as a generator coil. This is a big coil. It's about 1,000 feet of wire. This is my voltage meter here, reading on the coil, and then I have my amp probes in series with this. And basically, right now the coil is open. It's not loaded. There's nothing. I can plug things in. This one, at least capacitors. So first thing I want to show is, if I just spin this thing, you can see me just spin it by hand, you get a little bit of voltage out of that, just by hand spinning. So we're going to bring this reed switch in, and you can watch the voltage range as it goes up. That's being generated off of the big coil. I'm gonna plug in these and you'll be able to see how much faster. You can see the voltage is just climbing steadily. No peaking or any weird stuff. I'm gonna add this other coil here. So we're around 10.5 volts. No current because we have no load. Okay, we're gonna pull these two off of here again. These two coils. Now what I'm gonna show is, first I'm gonna do the big one. This is 4.7 microfarads. And there's no effect really. 2.8 volts. I can even short this out. You hear no effect shorting this coil. Now, that capacitor on there, now you saw how I started this off, just spun it up and put the reed switch. Now watch as I slow this down. Voltage starts climbing. Now we're at 16 volts, 28 milliamps. But she's running really slow. ...429 RPMs, 16 volts. So this is a lower resonant frequency for the coil with this capacitor. Now we'll take that capacitor out. We'll put a 1 microfarad in there. ...18, 25, 29, 31 at 23 milliamps. And that's just with one of these driver coils going. Now, remember when I hooked up each one of these and it got faster and faster successively, and I watched when I add each one, we're at 31 volts. You heard a little bit of a speed up there, but we're up to 47 volts. But she's still in a lockdown. This is not letting it go any faster than that. We're at 36 milliamps, 48 volts. Now we'll plug in the third coil. You can hear a hair of a speed up, but we jumped up to 53 volts by torquing it in the area that this is running with the 1 microfarad capacitor. Very strange. Now if I take this capacitor out, let's say if I short it, she just starts freewheeling, but then she'll come back down. You can hear it coming back down. Listen. Comes down quick. Speed up. Oh, I let go too far. See, it went past that point. But she wants to stay there. Let me see if I can 67 volts, 53 milliamps from this coil at these low speeds. Now, we'll take that out and we'll put, this is a 0.3 and a 0.2. It should be 0.5 microfarad, half of a microfarad. So she's going to be at a higher speed, like a smaller capacitor, higher frequency, 65 volts, 64, 35 milliamps. Now, if I take the capacitor out, watch the voltage. Even it just as it speeds up, we need to take both of them out. Yeah. We're at 10 volts, like we were before. You know, this is not loaded. I can move this coil away. No voltage. The rotor remains pretty much the same. Let me get this back on there. Alright. Put this. Now, if I could get it to go faster, this one capacitor. Let's see. This is the two, so that's half of a microfarad, 66 volts. Now, if I try to speed this up by hand, just by spinning it, watch the voltage. So just a little bit faster, she'll be going over 100 volts really quick. And that was just me tapping this rubber thing to get it to go just a little bit faster while this is in like a resonant lockup with the rotor. Doesn't want to let it go past that frequency. This is a little bit opposite from the speed up. I had speed up going on last night, and I got to play with this again because I added these diodes and to get rid of sparks and from the reed switch and everything, and I don't know why it happens. One day to the next, some things aren't the same as they were. So I got to play with it a little bit more, see. But this is the first time I've had some decent effects at low frequencies with coil and capacitors. Let's see. Running all three coils. RPMs. 39 volts, 25 milliamps. But I thought that was pretty cool. Let's take these out. Now, I imagine with the self-capacitance of the coil, I'd have to get up to 4,000 or 5,000 RPMs to get this to have some kind of reaction or short it out. Nothing. So you can see when I put the capacitor in, right now it's shorted out, so the capacitors aren't doing anything. I take that short off, and the capacitors bring it down, and then my voltage rises. You take the capacitors off, and you see the voltage. Should be 10 volts or so, like it was before. If you slow it down by hand, you're slowing it down. And watch your voltage. You can see the little bar at the bottom. It's pretty smooth on its decline. You know, no surprises there. But I thought it was pretty cool. Let's try this 4.7 again. I'm trying to get this low speed. When I get it down to the low speed, she wants, I think it was about 15 volts it wants to put out. Hang there. Oh, 20. Okay, she's hanging. Three coils, the bigger capacitor at this lower frequency, 19 volts, 35 milliamps. Oh, and also, this little magnet inside here, you see how it has a little fun there, how it has a little fun there, and it also has a little fun here. Now, if I take the capacitor out, no more magnet jumping. Nothing. Not until I get it back in a resonant state.